new handheld phone. Much better, eh? Using this thing. Cool. Oh yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't have an irrigation option on there to keep the dust down.
No. It's no dust removal app. Wishful thinking.
Is she a little bit jumpy today, isn't she?
Oh, she has.
Keep the focus. You can't get rough with your hands. And ask her to stay down, but support her with your leg.
What I worry about is she'll run me into the crash, or if I go close there.
She'll run away from that. She's not going to go to that. Just looking for a couple of circles that are nice and quiet and relaxed. Support it off your inside leg. Don't slow, get it back up to trot. When she does that, try and stay on the same route that you were going to ride anyway. And just fix it as best you can. Don't change your route because she's overreacted. Right, it's gone for 5 minutes. Good. One more circle and then change the rein through the circle. Okay, and change the rein through the circle. And go over the pole. And out to the left. Put more inside leg next time and hold her out closer to the fence. Off your inside leg. Hold her there now. Hold her there now. Push her out into that. That's better. Yeah. And that was better again than last time. Good job. Change your rein once more across the circle, across the pole. So turn out now the half 10 meter circle to the center. Across and to the right. All right, shoulder up, bury your hands. Inside leg, hold it to the fence. Now, push her over there. Okay, now you're gonna ride down the long side. That was nicely done. Turn across to the center pole and ride back towards us. Inside leg, inside bend. Good. Right, down the long side before the little mower comes back. Shoulder up. Soften, just soften. Get it back to the fence, get it back to the fence. Right, turning her that way is giving in to her. You should have stayed to the right towards the fence. Keep going, keep going. Put her there. Go back to the fence. No, you're not. Well, you're not facing her towards the fence to walk her to it to start with. You're trying to leg yield her to it. Turn her towards it. Turn her towards it. And say walk on. Come on. Come on. There you go. Keep going. reverse. Get your trot a little bit bigger.
Hey, stop. Walk on.
Back on your half circle. Window and you clamp up by sinking your hands down on it with her, leaning forward a little bit. One thing that does improve, your heels down. You get yourself really sunk in there, which is good. But you want that with your upright position and carrying your hands a little bit. Then you're there ready.
Yeah, well, there is some money in my budget, so it's got little.
She's got a speaker in. That's good. Does she have her?
Oh, yeah.
Teaching her with.
Yeah, well, because she can't quite hear in one ear, so.
Oh, that's so great. I've taken lessons with that. It's awesome.
I tried to give it to my ex-wife. Can you please make me dinner? Can you please do the dusting? Can you please make sure my food is ready when I get home? Didn't work.
Okay, I want you to ride down alongside the half circle.
I'm just going out, but I'll be back, okay? My horse is here.
Well, I'm not the boss here.
You have to tell
Mike. Mike's the manager.
And
are you going too, Mike?
Hey, Ash, I'm coming back, but I'm just running out. My horses are out.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, make sure you find your way back, okay?
I have to go to the garden store.
Are you going, Mike?
No, I've got to stay. I've got to.
I got to take some pictures of your equipment.
Drop one of my big machines off to Joe's to do a quick adjustment on it.
Well, we can do it later. I don't care.
So, I hate to take a picture without one of my big bangers.
No, you need the whole works.
Well, yeah, they got those are the two $1,700 machines.
Yeah,
well, I can do the job.
Well, those are better to take a picture of.
And then down alongside.
I had lunch at Lutz's today.
Next
time, I go every Friday to buy cheese, buns, not buns, bread. Hummus, other things. Yeah, that's what she said. And so I had the lasagna, Greek salad with homemade apple cider, which Tony made. Oh, it's so good.
Oh, that's it. Yeah.
So good.
Back onto the rail and let's have a horses in down the long side. Straighten out and half circle reverse. Come back to the fence line. Haunches in. A little bit too much. There we go, that's it. Straighten out, half circle reverse. Once more, haunches in. Good. Nice. Hold it. Straighten out. Ride straight ahead. Half circle reverse. And leg yield back to the fence. Leg yield back. Support it. Haunches in. Straighten up. Half circle. And leg yield back to the fence.
Nice.
Going. Tap. Smacker. Get her forward straight first. Now leg yield. Good. Trot large. At one more circle, and then next time in front of me, same circle again, a little bit longer and lower. Catches their attention, and it's enough to want to run away from it. It's more that she's, and the more she does it, the more she gets used to knowing that she can do it.
Yeah, I know. That's what's so worrisome.
And what's really important with a thing like that is if you're trying to go that direction to the fence, and she's wanting to go the other way, the moment you give into her by allowing her to turn away from it and come back to it, then she's won her battle.
Yeah.
You've got to persevere in the same direction all the time. Even if you end up going a little bit sideways down there, but you keep her nose facing in the same direction so that you have kept to what it was you wanted to start doing, and you look for an improvement the next time around. The moment you turn away, it's like you've given up and she's won the battle, okay? And she will try it again and again and again because you've given that once, she'll try it again. You know, it's not that you have to be dictatorial or nasty or mean to get your point across, but you need to be methodical on your approach and firm with it the first time, that hopefully it doesn't get pear-shaped and go out of kilter. And from there, you then work with it. If it's a slight misunderstanding, then you just look at rectifying it the next time. That's what the training's about. But the moment you give in and you let them turn away from it, they come back to it, they've won their battle, and I'll keep persevering to get that
done. So in the case where they back up the way she was, what do I do? Just
you really gotta, what to start with? It started with you leaning forward, Jack. Okay? So that's keeping up, and you slow your rhythm down. You don't try and look at keeping your rhythm up. You let it slow down, okay? And it's not a matter of trying to fix it now because she's done it to you already. But what it is next time out, you've got to be ready for a circumstance like that and just try and ride it correctly. Okay? And I'm not saying that she's not going to throw something at you, but it's your best way of getting through it. Okay? It's being bold. You know, she's not going to be really silly. At the moment she starts hopping like that, she's only hopping because you started bringing her shorter to start with. Now she feels she can't get away. If I am either here, what you're trying to do, control it that way. But because you've got tense, she's reacting to your tenseness, and that's what builds that.
Okay. Very hard to make myself stop getting tense.
You know, that's part of the reward and the adrenaline rush of riding is you have fears that come around with all of this. When you overcome that, that's a huge thing. You know, build the confidence and the wherewithal and have one or two of those trusting experiences that have worked for you to go back there and do it again.
Yeah.
And I think we've had a couple of them already. We have. But not enough to build your confidence that you could stay up and keep that rhythm going.
Yeah.
And see that it works. Okay, we're not going to push it too much more with it. Let's do a couple more circles in this direction here. Hey, Nippy. How are you?
Very well, thanks. And you?
I'm very good. Enjoying the warm weather?
Yes, very much so.
Stop! Every single time is a house there.
Very much.
Slow your trot down, come to a sitting trot. I want you over the pole at the top. Half a centimeter circle to the pole in the middle and out to the right. Imagine that there's another pole at the bottom, that the third pole is there. So from here, just a 10-meter circle to the right, over the imaginary pole, back to the pole, and then out to the left again. Eyes up, look where you're going. You want to be looking back to this, always looking 180 degrees across the circle. So from here, you're looking at the pole in the middle. That's it. Right, from there, you're looking to the right, to where the pole would be in the middle. And back to the pole in the middle. Look at it. It's that look that gets your shoulder in the right direction to create, to help create the curve.
Sam,
yeah.
I want to ask you something.
Okay, out to the right, you go large, 20 meter circle.
What's this?
And back over the pole here, and into that little figure
know.
Of eight in the other
okay.
direction.
I don't know either. I think because I'm holding up my remote handle.
Good.
Right? Weird. No, I just thought maybe you don't.
Yeah.
I don't think it's important.
Back to the pole in the middle, well done. Over the pole in the middle and look at the pole on your right hand side. Right now, that's it. Inside leg, inside bend. Had a bit more bend to start that half circle. Doesn't need the hand for her to lean into when she's going to get anxious. Trust me, the hand can be soft. Support is there with your teeth and your legs. And you can go softer with your hand, even if they're going to get a bit anxious. It doesn't have to build up into your hand that's being strong. Trust your hand can go soft and support with your leg and your once more, and you're going to do the same thing again. Much better hold this time. Right, rein back. One, two, three, four, and forward. Good. Don't get left behind when she goes forward. And pick up your trot. Good job. Long and low. Straight away. Good.
That's it.
Well, I'm gonna go like this today.
Listen.
Very discouraging. I got one.